How do you best evaluate the success of allergen cleaning? Visual inspection and analytical testing. Let's now look at the testing methods available and which ones are suitable for validation and which are suitable for verification. Commonly used allergen detection methods can be divided into two groups: those that need to be done in a lab using specialized equipment, and those that can be performed on-site using little or no specialized equipment. Let's look at the first group, the lab-based methods. This group can be subdivided into another two groups, direct and indirect methods. Direct methods detect specific proteins from the allergenic food in question, most often the allergenic proteins themselves. Indirect methods detect a marker associated with the allergenic food, for example, its DNA. Direct methods are generally preferred. There are two popular direct methods: an antibody-mediated technique called ELISA, or enzyme-linked immunosorbent assays, which detect protein via antibody binding, and a targeted proteomics technique called liquid chromatography-tandem mass spectrometry, or LCMS-MS, which detect allergenic proteins by looking for their peptides, which are their building blocks. The most commonly used indirect method is a DNA amplification technique called PCR, or polymerized chain reaction, and it detects specific unique parts of the DNA of the specific allergenic food. Lab-based methods are expensive to run and need skilled analysts and technical equipment. They are very sensitive, specific, and can generate quantitative results, making them ideal to support cleaning validation activities. Now let's look at the rapid on-site testing methods. These methods are cost-effective, mobile, and operators need very little technical skills. Three types have gained popularity in recent years. One, allergen-specific lateral flow devices, or dipstick tests, are qualitative or semi-quantitative immunochromatographic tests based on the ELISA technique and typically test a single allergen at a time. Total protein indicators, or total protein swabs, are designed to detect protein on equipment surfaces. They cannot discriminate between allergens and non-allergenic protein, but the rationale is, if a surface is protein-free, it's also reasonable to infer that it will also be allergen-free. These swabs are easy to use, sensitive, cost-effective, and results are easy to interpret. 3. Sensitive ATP swabs detect adenosine triphosphate, the energy currency of cells, on surfaces and in rinse water. They are not allergen-specific, thus, it is important to understand how ATP results correlate with the presence of allergen residue in your specific set of circumstances. This can be done during your allergen cleaning validation study. Watch videos 6 and 7 for more in-depth discussion on allergen-specific lateral flow devices and total protein indicators. How do you choose a rapid on-site testing kit? Multiple factors may guide your choice, but there are a few key considerations. 1. Cost. The cost of the kits itself, and also the cost of auxiliary equipment that you may need. 2. How many allergens you control. Protein swabs may be more practical and cost-effective when you control multiple allergens because they can detect protein, thus you can verify the absence of multiple allergens. On the flip side, if you control one allergen, let's say gluten, it is feasible to use a gluten-specific lateral flow device. 3. How easy it is to perform the tests. Allergen-specific lateral flow tests are easy to perform compared to ELISA, but operators still need basic scientific knowledge. For total protein swabs, on the other hand, operators need no technical skills. 4. The sensitivity of the kit, which refers to the limit of detection and what it was calibrated against. And finally, 5. The efficacy of the kit. If the kit is not able to detect the allergenic residue in your set of circumstances, it's not adequate and therefore not a viable option. In summary, not all allergen detection methods are equal. Thus, it is important to understand before submitting a sample to a lab or before choosing a rapid on-site testing kit to know what the method or the kit measures and whether it's the most appropriate method for your specific set of circumstances. In the next episode, I'm going to look at allergen-specific lateral flow devices.